grade. You have adults asking you what you want to be when you grow up. What are your dreams for the future? As for me, Mashiro Moritaka, I don't know. I still haven't decided yet. The normal path is to get into the best high school you can, so you can get into the best university, and then get a job at the best company you qualify for, so you can live a normal life. That's why I go to school every day. I mean, it'd be easier just to stay at home and play video games, but I don't want to cause problems for my parents. I'm not going to be one of those internet-connected shut-ins mooching off my folks or bounce from job to job making minimum wage forever. That's why I'm taking the normal route. I'm becoming a salaryman.
Yeah, but I'd still rather...
The people who do well at those big companies are the people who do well now. Our rankings are already fixed. They'll just extend into the future. A predictable future. It's tedious, but that's life. At least that's how I see it after 14 years of trying to be a good student. I read this thing in a book once. It said that the greatest event one can achieve in their lifetime is to find love. Who are they kidding? It sounds like a line used by some pickup artist. For someone like me, who can't even talk to the girl he likes, love is just sad and painful. Unrequited love just sends me deeper into despair.
Midterms are tomorrow. Be sure to hit those books.
Psycho, let's go home.
Sure. Hey, Psycho. Suzuki, let's go.
Here.
Thanks. Exam starts tomorrow, huh?
Who cares? At least we get out early.
Well, let's make good use of that time.
Show business. I'll never be a professional athlete, but I have literary talent and you.
leave us? Manga. Manga has become a worldwide phenomenon. We will be immortalized in the pages of manga!
Just so we're clear, you'll bring your award-winning writing skill, and I'll do the drawings? Interesting.
So then?
No, I refuse.
I refuse, huh? I know you're into manga, I can tell.
I can't become a manga artist.
Huh?
The only people who truly succeed in manga are born to draw geniuses. The rest of us are just taking a gamble.
A gamble?
Professional manga artists are people who make their living solely through drawing manga. Even if you succeed in getting your series published in a weekly magazine, your manga gets ranked according to the reader surveys. If it's not popular enough, it gets cut in 10 weeks. If you can create one mega hit or several smaller semi-hits, that's one thing. If not, you're just rolling the dice. The people who make a living purely off of manga are about 0.001%. That's 1 in 100,000.
What's with the statistics? Who'd you hear that from?
I guess I can tell him. My uncle was a manga artist. In other words, he was just a gambler.
Huh?
That's right.
Was a manga artist. You're kidding me.
I'm not.
Who? What's his name?
It was a long time ago. You probably don't...
Who is he?
Taro Kawaguchi. He had a series through Shonen.
What? Your uncle wrote Superhero Legend? I used to watch the anime when I was a kid. I bought all the manga, too. I loved that title growing up. That settles it. You have the DNA of a manga artist. It's already in your blood. And if there's something we want to know, we can just ask your uncle.
What are you talking about, DNA? He was my uncle, not my dad. Besides, he's already...
Wait a minute. Now that you mention it, Superhero Legend's artwork was horrible. But you're actually good. I guess DNA has nothing to do with it.
Well, it's irrelevant, because I'm not doing it anyway. If that's your condition, then you can keep my notebook. See you around, thief.
Hold it! It may be a gamble, but you'll never win the lottery if you don't buy a ticket. Sure, it's a long shot, but how else do you win the jackpot?
That's exactly the sort of thing my uncle used to say.
Come on, we can do this.
All right, look. There's a difference between writing a manga and writing a book report.
I know that. I wrote my essays after carefully calculating the best way to earn the approval of the teachers. Now I'll do the same with publishers and fanboys.
Wouldn't your time be better spent going for a Pulitzer?
Oh, no. In this day and age, manga makes way more money, and I like it better anyway. It's like a dream.
Okay, then why don't you do the drawing yourself? Or become a staff manga writer. You can apply for that.
What? You want to find yourself a cozy little position as a civil servant or something?
I haven't decided what I'm gonna do yet.
Then why won't you do this?
Why? You know, I'm not even sure myself. But probably because it's gonna be too much of a pain. Well, I'm gonna go home and study. Thanks for my book.
Wait! You're just going to coast through life like that. That's really enough for you.
Hey, I'm the normal one. Their whole life planned out before they even graduate.
There's no point in waiting. I know what I want. Most people coast through life, never daring to take a chance. You and I could do something great.
Man, you're persistent. Fine, have it your way. I'll go home and I'll think about it.
You will?
The answer's still probably gonna...
That's okay,
no.
Just as long as you really think about it carefully. If the answer's still no, then I'll give up.
Back in elementary school, I totally wanted to be a manga artist. Hey, Uncle, what made you decide to become a manga artist?
Actually, I'm really more of a gambler.
Oh, right. So what made you decide to become a gambler?
Because I wanted to be popular with the girls.
Do girls like manga artists?
Well, I thought that if I became rich and famous, then maybe I'd be popular with the ladies. Don't tell anybody, okay? There was this girl that I had a crush on when I was in middle school.
Oh.
But unfortunately, we both ended up graduating without ever talking.
Is that the end?
Well, on graduation day, I did get a letter from her.
Was it a love letter? Awesome!
No, unfortunately, it was just a letter of congratulation and wishing me luck in the future, you know, stuff like that.
Huh.
I did write her back to thank her for the letter and offer her congratulations. But we went to different high schools, so we never really saw each other.
We kept writing and sending letters, though.
That actually sounds kind of nice.
Eventually, we both graduated from high school, and she was immediately hired by a top corporation. I just went to some fourth-rate college. I knew it probably wasn't a good idea, but I'd gotten in my head that I wanted to marry her, so I just kept thinking, what can I do to try to impress her? That's when I got the idea.
So you became a manga artist!
By this point, she'd already done a pretty good job working her way up the corporate ladder, and I was just a rookie manga artist doing a monthly magazine series. So I didn't really have much to offer her in the way of financial security. But when Superhero Legend finally became an anime...
Then you confessed!
I was too late. She'd already married somebody else.
What?
I guess I waited just too long. But then I realized I never would have tried so hard if it wasn't for her.
What? 2 years later?
Talent? Azuki wants to be a voice actress.
What? What do I say? I don't know what to say. I'll do the drawings, and he'll write the stories.
Oh my gosh, I knew it! This is the best news ever! You two will definitely make it!
Look at her eyes. They're all sparkly like stars. She's pretty. So if our manga ever gets turned into an anime, we would be honored if you would play the heroine.
Really? I promise I'll work really hard so I can become a professional voice actress and be in your anime. Thank you so much.
Whoa, look at her smile. And those eyes just staring at me so close. You are so cute, Azuki.
There was this girl that I had a crush on when I was in middle school. I wanted to marry her.
Like for the